The Small Rural Hospital Transition Project, or SRHT for short, supports small rural hospitals nationally by providing on-site consultations and education to bridge the gaps between the current healthcare system and the emerging healthcare delivery and payment system. SRHT works with selected hospitals to identify and disseminate financial, operational, or quality improvement best practices and successful strategies to share with other rural hospital and network leaders. This video showcases the outcomes and successes of a SRHT project hospital that implemented the recommended best practices.
We were just hitting that margin, just enough to keep the hospital open, and we were really in a place where we needed to do more for our community and for our patients. And the SRHT project actually gave us that opportunity to reevaluate what potential services we could offer here at Roosevelt. What SRHT did for us is it gave us a different perspective.
When we applied for the SRHT grant, we had a brand new CEO, a brand new CFO. I was new in my position as business office director, and we really needed some help prioritizing what we needed to work on. We were having some issues financially. We had a lot of change within the organization, and SRHT came in and they were able to help us, and it was completely manageable.
We were focused on reducing costs, and the consultation really shifted our focus to growth. We need to be expanding into markets that make sense for us. And so our whole strategy now for our strategic plan going forward is centered around growth. We felt like this was an opportunity to really look at our organization and make the improvements that we needed to make in order to make sure that we were going to be here for decades to come.
The on-site consultation has helped me as a leader create value in our organization by recommending a dashboard, which is a productivity tool that keeps track of our metrics. We've been able to increase our collection goals by over 100,000 just recently, as we've met our goal every month for 6 months.
When we reviewed our charge master, that actually helped us evaluate our current practices across the organization when it came to patient care, how we were billing, charging, and gave us an opportunity to really focus on where are we doing really great, what are the services that we're providing a lot of, how can we do that better for our patient, and it still have a cost value to the patient, and them still get something out of that.
We've been able to now be in the black, and we expect to have nearly $1 million of positive revenue this year, whereas we have no history of us being in the black before for this facility, so that's very exciting for us.
So it wasn't just updating the charges. One of the recommendations Stroudwater gave to us was to change how we bill our surgical procedures based on the type of procedures we perform here. So for an organization this size, it made a huge impact on our bottom line. I'm really excited about the swing bed program, and the reason that ties into our staffing on MedSurg is with the increased productivity tool, we're sending staff home when we don't have patients now. So we honestly, based on our projections, we don't think swing bed is going to make us a lot of extra revenue because we're not a critical access hospital. But what it will do for us is allow us to stabilize our staffing, so we're not losing good nurses who don't feel like they're not getting enough hours.
We've been able to find multiple opportunities to improve our financial position. One of those being that we've been able to reduce our bad debt by 25%, just over $1 million in less than a year. We've been able to increase our point of service collections by 22% on the clinic side and by 15% on the hospital side as a result of implementing a system called Freesia, and also providing estimates to our patients for surgical services and pre-scheduled services. As a result of the charge master review, our hospital has been able to increase our collections by $2.25 million from 2017 to 2018, and $1.4 million of that was shortly after SRHT came on site and did a charge master review. We performed a FEMA, which is a failure result effect analysis, and we were able to identify multiple places where the claims were failing. And as a result, we've been able to reduce our past timely filing by over 52%, no prior authorization denials by 77%, and our registration errors by 60%, resulting in more revenue coming into our hospital. Our days in AR were 71. And today they are sitting at 50. So we've seen a decrease in 21 days in just a year.
Through the ED Redirect program, we were able to actually reduce non-acute patient visits by 25% in the first 3 months. And that was really through the process of screening them in triage with the provider, and we were able to send over anywhere from 20 to 40 patients a month that were non-acute. We call them level fives, and they had the opportunity to still get very timely quality care, but in our clinic. That made a big difference just on the flow of the ER. Now our one doctor and our nursing staff can really focus on the really critical patients that needed their attention.
When this SRHT consultation started, we had one behavioral health nurse provider. She was a nurse practitioner. And we knew that our community was really underserved for behavioral health. So we've since recruited two additional nurse practitioners. So we've got three nurse practitioners and an RN case manager for our behavioral health population. And that's so important for our community, but also for our schools, because we're seeing more and more young people coming forward. As we destigmatize mental health, they're coming forward for help. And we feel like for the first time, we're really able to provide the help our community needs. We've brought in other agencies such as law enforcement, mental health resources in our community. So we're really trying to make this a collaborative community effort.
So one of the SRHT projects that we had was expansion into a new market. After they did the review or the community needs assessment for us here, they found that there was a shortage of primary care in the Clovis market. We've been received by open arms. They're very excited that we've got more providers now coming to serve their community and are excited to have that opportunity. We will have two providers in that location. We think we'll be serving about 2,500 patients.
We really went to more of an on-demand staffing model. They're getting out of here by 4 o'clock every day. So the staff is happier. We don't have the overtime costs that we did, and it's just improved the entire organization. We also staggered shifts. So instead of having everyone come in at 6 o'clock in the morning and we only had two patients, we've staggered our shifts according to our patient load.
Being in an ACO allowed us to see that we were referring a lot of things out that we should have been doing in-house. We bought our own eye exam equipment. We've trained our own staff, and we're going to be able to bill for that service. So that increases our bottom line, keeps our patients closer to us, to their primary care providers, and allows us to get 100% of the reports back because they don't leave here now.
As a small rural hospital, we all wear so many hats, and we have to find ways to get the job done and be successful at the end of the day while taking excellent care of our patients.
I want everybody to know the value. I want them to know the value of the program. This opportunity and the SRHT project for us has been life-changing. We felt like we had support. We felt like we had a plan.
The on-site consultation by the SRHT team really helped us focus. I think we thought things were just not within our reach before, and through the consultation process, we found out that they absolutely are.